All right, guys, got a pretty cool one here today for you. This is the Autel Maxi AP, AP200C, code reader and service tool. And it's your standard, you know, OBD2 code reader for vehicles 1996 or newer in the U.S. But it's also probably the cheapest way to do an auto bleed. If you're a guy that's doing your own work at home and you need to do an auto bleed, say you had a brake line, you know, brake on you and your brake fluid drained out of the front or rear brakes on your vehicle, or if you had a caliper go bad and you had to change it and you got a bunch of air in your system, if you get air trapped in your ABS module, this is probably now the cheapest way to do an auto bleed. I did a video about this a few years ago, and what at that time I believed was the cheapest way to do an auto bleed, instead of bringing it to a dealer and having them charge you, you know, at least a minimum of an hour. At the time, that was the cheapest way to do an auto bleed, and now I believe this is the cheapest way. So let me show you what's in here. You get the box, you get the OBD2 dongle itself, I guess you'd call it, and then under the packing you get a quick reference guide, which I can show you, and then just a little lanyard for the device itself. In the quick reference guide, it talks about you download the app, install the app, and then once the app is installed, you just scan this barcode on the device itself, or you could type in the serial number. But it's easy, you just type in the barcode. It pairs this thing with your phone, and it's pretty simple. Now, I've already set up my phone with this app, and I will say that I had a little bit of trouble setting it up, but it was my fault. I actually killed that operation while it was still installing, so I had to start over and redo it from scratch. But once you get the app installed, this is what it'll look like. You'll have to create an Autel account with a username and password. It's free. And then this is where you'll be at. And then you can scan this barcode. You can scan this barcode, and it'll pair this with the device. Of course, I have to have my Bluetooth on here, I believe. Yep. Now, this thing only gets its power when it's plugged into the OBD2 port. So you'll need to plug this into your vehicle and have the key on, and then this thing will have power, and then your phone will be able to find the device. So I'm going to reach down and plug this in. Okay, I'm all hooked up here. So to give you an idea of what this device can do, when you buy this device, it by default is an OBD2 code reader, all engine codes. That does that all the time. And for the first year, it includes ABS auto bleed and supplemental restraint system like airbag codes and stuff like that. But this device will also do oil reset, electronic parking brake, battery management, DPF filter, steering angle sensor, throttle relearns, that type of stuff. And you can see that each one of them costs an extra fee. And I know that it kind of sucks having to pay extra for extra functionality, but this device, to begin with, is really cheap. It's about, I don't want to get into exact pricing because these videos stay on YouTube for years and pricing can change, but at the time, this device is about half price of the device that I did an auto bleed video about a few years back. And so back then, that was the cheapest route, and now this is the cheapest route to do an auto bleed. And you know, these subscription based services, if you buy these, they're good for a year. And you know, considering, you know, if you had a big Autel scanner like this thing, like the big, you know, Maxicom 808 or 908, you know, these things are about $1,000 a year to update. So in comparison, this is pretty reasonable. And so I'm going to do an auto bleed just to show you that I can do it, how it functions with this particular device. Click on GM. We'll do automatic selection. We'll read the VIN. We'll click OK. Automatic transfer case. It's scrolling across the top there. Yes. It's four button selectable. I have manual dual zone. I have an up level. It's equal to or under. It's a rear drum brake truck. That all looks right. I shut the engine off. The engine doesn't need to be running for the auto bleed, but the key does need to be on. So, we'll go to hot functions. Anti-lock brake system. Automated bleed. This is important. If there's a help button, please press it to get information. Well, I don't need to get the information because I've already seen it, but we'll just go to continue. Check the brake fluid, set it in park, hit start. Shift transmission to park or neutral, yes. Apply and hold brake pedal. Now, if you can hear that in the background. There it is. So, officially completed the auto bleed. So I'd like to talk a little bit about the auto bleed itself. The auto bleed is not magic. It does not magically remove air bubbles completely from the system without using a tool. Okay? The air bubbles still need to be manually bled from the system the traditional way. However, it's common for air bubbles to get stuck within the ABS module. So say this was your ABS module and you had brake lines coming in and brake lines going out or what have you. If you have a brake line failure or if something happens where your brake system, all the fluid drains out of it from a rupture or a bad caliper or whatever happens, you get air in the system and then you try to bleed it out. Well, as you're bleeding it, the air bubbles get trapped inside this ABS module and you cannot get them out without running an auto bleed. So all the auto bleed does is it runs that pump and it kind of vibrates the box, the ABS module, and it gets those bubbles to migrate from within the box out into the brake lines where they can then be bled their traditional way. So running the auto bleed is not the end of the process. It's just part of the process. Once you do this, you still need to bleed the brakes traditionally, manually, and watch for air bubbles to come out of your brake fluid. And then you may want to do this again, run the auto bleed, and then manually bleed. Run the auto bleed, then manually bleed. Keep doing that until all the bubbles are gone, until you don't see any more bubbles, and then you're finished. This auto bleed by itself is not magic. And I think a lot of people were confused on that on my first earlier video. In fact, if you'd like to see that video, I'll put a card up here and I'll also put a link down below in the description and even in the first pinned comment. But this device by Autel, I mean, look how small that is, pretty compact. I got this just simply because I go on a lot of road trips and, you know, carrying this thing is going to be a lot easier than carrying this big, you know, Android Autel tablet. Plus, you know, if I'm on a road trip somewhere and my vehicle gets broken into and I'm at a hotel, I don't want to lose my $2,000, you know, 908 scanner when this inexpensive scanner is all I pretty much need for road trips. So it'll do normal engine codes, live data. I don't believe there's another system that's cheaper that allows you to do an auto bleed. And I also believe this is the only one that allows you to do it from a cell phone with a dongle-based setup. If you're interested in this device, check the description below. I hope this video was helpful to you. Please be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.